Do you have that one friend in your life who is a really brilliant source of advice, whatever the situation that you hit? For me, that person is Alex Gordon-Shute. She founded Ithaca Partners, which is a search consultancy, a headhunters for directors of communications and directors of corporate affairs. And in that role, she has given real thought to business manners, how to handle situations when people are completely triumphant and have just got the job of their dreams. And people who are in utter despair because they've been rejected from the thing that they really, really wanted. Alex has also given a lot of thought to how to protect her own time, because the risk of working in any sort of recruitment job is that all of us make a beeline for you every single time that we need a CV refresh or a new job or want advice or want to meet the person that you know that they know. And Alex has beautifully brilliant techniques for managing all of that incoming without ever being rude and without ever not giving people the time that they really, really need.
Big three headlines are around listening twice as much as you're speaking, being curious, and being enthusiastic. Because ultimately, the world prefers to interact with people who hear them, who are enthusiastic about being in that conversation, and who are interested in what they've got to say. The boundaries are be kind wherever you can be, but yes, you do have to create some boundaries. I think one of the big boundary questions that I've honed over the years, I first experimented with it about 10 years ago, and it's quite an important question for me these days, which is to say to the person who's recommending me to have the conversation with their friend or whoever, if this was the one favor I was going to do for you this year, is it this one? Is this the favor? Because what that does is it really focuses someone's mind on the fact that they're giving away your time. And please be mindful that that's a precious resource. And if somebody's response to that is, do you know what, it absolutely is the one favor I would ask you to do for me this year, well, great, then it's serious. Then it's really important to them and it really means something. And of course, I will try and help. Quite often the answer is, oh, no, actually, Alex, it's not the one favor I would ask you to do me this year. And it sort of sorts you out. It's a good filter. I think it is about that sense of wanting the differentiation for me personally and for my search business to be that people feel their interactions with me and my colleagues are deeper and more meaningful and more thoughtful. And that means more personal. That means we've bothered. We're taking the time to really think about them. Non-technical sort of handwritten moments that they mean something for people. So literally handwritten in the sense that when we place a candidate in a job, the week before they start in their new job, I do write them a handwritten card to say good luck in the new job, hope it goes well. And the handwritten bit I think is important. A client at the end of each search also gets a proper letter, a kind of paper, I mean pre-COVID and hopefully post-COVID as well, but a proper letter and not just an electronic form of communication. My view on that is something edible or something beautiful are things that people love. You know, the things that I thank people with tend to be very beautiful bunches of flowers. If they're women, it's very, very unusual that any woman doesn't love to get a really beautiful bunch of flowers. And I have a couple of particularly classy florists that I tend to use. So in London, it tends to be McQueen's. Outside London, some people called the Real Flower Company, and they are very, very beautiful flowers. And similarly, a bottle of something special.
I think I would put into the more budget but more affordable end that Marks and Spencer's are pretty reliable and good value. Yeah. I mean, don't get me wrong, if anyone's sending me flowers, I'll take the McQueen. But if you want the more budget end, I think they're the most reliable that I've found, and they also get the nationwide distribution.
The world is so electronic these days that having bad news delivered by email or in a text message feels particularly grim. Our message boxes are all full of messages all the time, and it feels like someone really hasn't bothered. One of my goddaughters recently taught me how to use WhatsApp voicemail messenger. So I've been using that recently because what it does is it means that you can call someone without bothering them that they need to answer the call, but still be a voice rather than a message. One of the things that's really hard, particularly if you're in a business where you need to look for work all the time, look for clients and bring clients in, which is a position I'm in with a search business, I think it's particularly hard to be elegant in how you chase someone that you think might have some business for you. What you don't want is to be an irritant ever. But on the other hand, it's worth remembering that, particularly again in COVID, people feel incredibly busy and very sort of up to the brim with their capacity for, you know, what they're dealing with. And so quite often it is cock up, not conspiracy, that they haven't come back to you, and you want to give them that chance. So in times like that, I do a certain amount at the beginning, which can be online. And then after a while, I will move things to voicemail or something that feels much more human. And I have in recent times of one particularly up to the brim client or potential client who I hope we'll be working with in the next week or so, I have got to the point where I've left a couple of messages on his voicemail just saying, I really don't want to be your stalker. And please, if you don't want this conversation, that's really fine. But I think you do from what you've said. And I just would love to have it so that we can get going. Being human and using that more human, perhaps a bit jokey style, I think means you don't become an irritant in the same way. I think authentic relationships can only be based on honesty. It's part of why I'm proud of the work that we do, is that if the honesty has been in the relationship with candidates and with clients all the way through, then it gives everybody a much higher sense of confidence that this is going to work. This truly is a job that could be their perfect job. And they know what the downsides are. No organization is perfect and no candidate is perfect. You know, I don't deal in unicorns. I deal in real human beings. So talking to the client about, you know, the pros and cons of different candidates and different backgrounds of people, and talking to the candidate about, well, the organization isn't perfect, but this is the big opportunity. This is what could be fun about it. That honesty becomes a really important part of why it's going to be successful. And similarly, it's often an important part of why it might not work. As with all memory games, asking the teacher how they remember the name of everybody in the class within the first hour of the September term, you can make sure there are games and tricks and specific things that you mentally, you label someone with that label or with that label, and it helps you remember them. It's hard. It is
you must
hard.
Get caught out. You must be at the gym or something and somebody says, oh, Alex, and you haven't got a clue.
I do get caught out. I mean, at times like that, of course, being a posh talking Sloane is quite helpful because I can always do the, oh, darling. And that's sometimes helpful. But it's, yeah, I'm not infallible on that one. None of us are.
I kind of thought that I was going to edit Alex's piece down to shorter than what you've just heard, but actually everything she said was really practical and really valuable, and I've left it all in. The thing I would particularly urge you to think about is working out how, in your world, you can say no really politely, really respectfully, in a way that guards your time. And it goes back to the deep work issue that we were discussing last week. How do we defend our time so that we can get done the things that we need to? Now, the question whether this is gendered, oh my God, my inbox is exploding. You've all sent me amazing, long, thoughtful messages. It's just incredible. I'm working through them and I'm going to be sharing some of the thoughts next week. I look forward to seeing you then. Take care.